you by my side. Come on and take a free ride. Take a free ride. Come on and sit here by my side. Come on and take a free ride.
Phillips here at JamPlay.com. We're looking today at the song Free Ride, originally recorded by the Edgar Winter Group and released in 1973. It was a huge hit. I'm sure many, if not all of you, have heard this song before. We're going to take a look at two different guitar parts that go on here. There's the rhythm part and then there's the lead part. So we're going to jump into the rhythm part right here. And there are three distinct sections for this song. So first section is the signature lick of the song that starts right off the bat. So it's probably the lick you'd recognize most from the song. And it starts with a slide up to the 9th fret on the 5th string. And then we're gonna hit 7th, 7th, 7th on strings 2, 3, and 4. So basically we're outlining a D chord over F with the 3rd on the bottom. Then what we're going to take is our second finger here on the 8th fret of the 2nd string. Then we're going to skip a string and hit the 9th fret on the 4th string here. Then we're going to mute the string between. We're going to slide up 2 frets. So. And then we're going to come back down those 2 frets. Then back to the D shape. And then you're gonna do one eanda on the muted strings. So that much so far. And it starts on beat 4. So 1, 2, 3. Okay, so let's take it nice and slow. 1, 2, 3. So you get that those chicka chickas in there, and it kind of implies the beat. So you got, okay. And then the next part, we're gonna slide to that same shape, same D shape. Then this time we're gonna hammer on to the 10th and 11th fret. Then back to that D shape. So. And then we're going to jump all the way down here to our regular root shape A. So you can hit, skip the lowest string, 0, 2, 2, 2. That's a quick hit, so it sounds like 2, 3. Again. The biggest things that you have to look at are keeping the pulse. Boom, ba, bum, ba, da, bum, bum. Boom, ba, bum, bum, bum. But also, because you're doing so much sliding and hammer on, especially this first part, you gotta watch over sliding or under sliding. So you gotta make sure to target that. Start nice and slow. It's a real loose kind of riff, but at the same time, it's very precise, otherwise it won't sound right. So let's do that much again, nice and slow. One, two, three. Again. And you've got the chicka chickas at the end of both of those measures. Let's do it again. We'll get a little closer to record tempo. About here. One, two, three. So you're getting that groove going. Make sure you keep a steady pulse. And then you'll be grooving along. And let's do it one more time about the actual tempo of the song. One, two, three. And then next we're going to take a look at the verse riff, but spend some time on this lick. This is the signature lick of the song. It's going to be the one that if you ever play it in front of people, it's going to be the one that they recognize. And so you want to make sure you get it nice and accurate. And if you want to do your own version of it, at least spend some time learning how they did it first, and then you can kind of go your own way with it. So come back in the next scene. We're going to take a look at the verse riff.